Oh my goodness, you people have made it to week three. And Shadow's still seeding the fields.
This is what happens when you're the free labor on someone else's farm. You get delegated to the menial tasks.
Yes. I'm watching the flag flap in the breeze and the trees move, and I'm just kind of perched up here in a safe position so I can't get run over by an angry worker. And, yeah.
And, you know, the funny thing is, when we started, I was like, can we put GPS in the tractors? And Daretire was like, no, we can't afford it. So I can't even watch Netflix while I'm doing this. It's just all steering.
What can I say? We could have put a compass in here so you could at least have a compass to look at.
You know what I can't wait for is, Glance.
Finishing your field?
Yes, that too. But I was never a big fan of Inspector Mod. I thought it was too clunky and took up too much of the screen. I really like Glance, because if you pulled up the F1 menu, it would hide Glance, and if you put away the F1 menu, it was just small text in the upper left corner of your screen that was color-coded, so you could find the information you wanted right away, and didn't have to, and it took up like no space on your screen. So I can't wait for that to be ported over.
I reviewed a mod the end of November that was sort of like that, but it was for prices. So it would pull up the highest price for all of the products that you have available to sell.
That would be nifty.
And if the price was increasing, it would display it in green. Yeah, so it did seem nifty. I'm yawning now because I'm so hungry. I'm yawning. I don't know how that works, but that's how it works. Also, watching you go up and down the field is, you know, about what you would expect.
Sorry, viewers.
Oh, hey, I have a bone to pick with you from weeks ago now, even though it's like from today because you made the comment today. Just waiting for Trabant the game.
Yeah. He said Eastern European car. So.
Yes, I know.
Yeah.
You don't like Jalopy?
Yeah. It's, well, I saw the, I mean, I know Jalopy's kind of a generic term, but, like, I saw the screenshot, I haven't actually seen the video yet, I saw the screenshot of the video on Twitter, and I was like, my first thought was, that's a Trabant.
No, it's not a Trabant. Or wait, is it a Trabant?
Inspired now, by Trabant.
Now I'm thinking it might. I mean, it's not like I'm doing anything that's really useful right now. Might as well look up. You're driving a... Well, it'd be helpful if you tell us what the car is. It is a... Please hold. A Leica. Leica? Leica? Laika 601 Deluxe.
All those Eastern Bloc cars are pretty much the same thing anyway.
Pretty much. The best part is the developer of that game. He actually worked on the F1 simulator franchise from 2009 through 2014.
Really?
Mm-hmm. That's why I'm like, the game, even in early access, is great. It's got a few issues. I mean, there was an issue a while ago where if you ran out of gas at high speed, the car would flip over.
Ha! That sounds like a farming simulator issue.
Yeah, pretty much. But I mean, it is in early access, and they're constantly putting out these updates, so.
I'm gonna have to check out that video. I'll be honest, like, I saw the title, and I immediately thought, oh great, it's gonna be another simulator we can make fun of, but no, if it's actually decent, that's good.
Yeah. I mean, I think a lot of people will be put off by the artwork, the aesthetic.
So many people are, and it irks me.
Yeah. I mean, these are the same people who play Minecraft, so it's like, well...
Yeah. But they play Minecraft with the shaders and with the 256 by 256 texture packs.
Yeah.
It still looks like blocks, people. Get over it.
I am trying to find a good pack to do another Let's Build, but that's hard to do now.
I would like to do a Minecraft series, but I don't have time. I've been doing pretty good this week, keeping up with like one video a day and a couple live streams thrown in, but I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to keep that up. So.
Well, I mean, it is the this week that we're recording this is the Thanksgiving week, so it's not like you were doing much most of the week.
Well, that's true, but my work schedule, my job is outside working in an equipment yard as my day job, and I'm still in school for EMT, obviously, so, but, yeah, my day job is very seasonal-ish, so I went from working, like, 50, 55 hours a week to working 10, 15, so, like, barely enough to pay my bills. And basically, I'm using that plus what I've saved up over the summer to pay my bills so I can... It's actually kind of nice for now, but I know I'm going to have to get a new job. I'm hoping I can ride it out until I get an EMS job, but we'll see.
See, just about every week for me is working 60 hours. Mush. You know what they need? I've just decided, and I know Hitman would agree with me, they need a device to whip your workers with.
Oh, jeez. I would disagree with that. Unless you're referring to the AI.
Well, I mean, they're fair game too, but, you know.
As well.
And
I wish the AI, like, letters would stay consistent. So, like, your first helper is always helper A, and your second helper is always helper B. It'd make remembering names so much easier. But, like, you get helper A, and then you get helper G, and then you get helper J, and then you get helper C. And it's like, all right, what did I name you guys again?
That's why I just don't name them.
I thought I'd give it a try now that they're actually, like, labeled with letters. I was like, oh, A is going to be... Adam, or Alfred. I think I named G Geralt, because I was just playing some Witcher beforehand. And
did you finish Witcher?
No.
Ah. Did you just pick it up at 3, or did you play 1 and 2 as well?
I've just picked it up at 3. I had actually not heard of it before 3.
Ah.
Which is, I know, kind of sacrilege, but...
No, I mean, a lot of people didn't pick it up before 3, because 3 was very high production value, and I guess 2 kind of slid under the radar of a lot of people, and 1 was just, yeah, 1.
A typical launch game.
Well, I mean, it's still okay. I have trouble playing it because it behaves as its era behaves, so... A lot of times you're like, I can make it through that opening. Oh no, that's an invisible wall. Never mind.
Gotcha. So complete subject change.
Shocking.
How do you feel about the like the Harry Potter universe? Are you a fan or not a fan or indifferent? Or...
I haven't read. I've actually been looking to buy the books, but I haven't gotten around to it. So I know nothing. there's Hufflepuffles and something else, and they hate each other, and then there's no giant dragons and there's no One Ring, so there's some minuses.
No, there are some giant dragons actually. Just not like talking ones and stuff. Anyway, because a new movie just came out, but it's set in the Harry Potter universe, but it's not Harry Potter, like it's not at the school even slightly. It's called Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. It was actually a really good movie. I just saw it last night.
I haven't been to a movie theater since Avatar.
I never saw Avatar.
I only saw it because I was on site at a client site and it was the weekend and there was nothing else to do, so.
Oh, huh. Now, are you referring to Blue People Avatar or Last Airbender Avatar?
Blue People.
Okay. Yeah, never saw that one either.
Yay, we're done with that!
Yeah.
So now
my ankle hurts from holding the gas pedal down. There's no cruise control in these.
There we go. 120 times speed.
Huzzah!
Oh, wait, we could also... Plant growth, Nermal. I hate Nermal, he's a stupid cat. I also hate Mondays when there's no lasagna involved.
Garfield?
Yes,
I feel like that's
Garfield.
Garfield.
Yes, that's Garfield. This is where time super fast forward would be helpful.
Right. Oh, I can't pick up anything.
I know. I was trying to any pick up stuff. I was going to like throw stuff in front of you. It was really annoying.
You could have always cut down a tree.
I would have had to buy. I would have had to buy a chainsaw, and that's $1,000.
That's true. I wish you could break down the little trees just by ramming tractors into them.
You mean like how you knock down trees and spin tires?
You know, a game I'm disappointed didn't do better was Agricultural Simulator.
You mean the crappy UIG game that crashed every 5 seconds?
Yes. I don't mean did better sales-wise. I mean did better production-wise.
The problem
because I feel like they had a lot of good ideas.
The problem with the whole thing is it started out with that with the statement, that UIG game.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hop, 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 hop.
So are you going to go for, like, a theme with this farm, or are you just going to do some of everything?
Let's see. What do people hate the most? I'm going to do forestry. No. Well, one thing I want to do is biogas, but I'm only going to do biogas when I put in the biogas extension. But that's a long ways away, because just to start the facility is going to cost $180,000. And that
is the biogas extension out yet?
Yeah, it's out.
I'm going to have to look into that.
So to start the biogas at 100% capacity costs $250,000.
Holy cow.
So I'm like, well, that'll be a ways away. Hey, look, we have some plant. Do we have to do something to them? Burn them. Oh, no, fertilize them. Okay. All right. All of the fields have popped. You know the drawback to that? All the fields are going to need to be harvested at the same time. I don't remember. Where is refill? R. Okay. Now, I must drive my tractor onto the field and hope it does not does not destroy our croppage. Will it destroy the crops? Probably.
Yeah.
No? Okay.
So, correct me if I'm wrong, but is this the time where you get the whip?
Nope. Because the whip would mean I would deviate from my course and possibly destroy the plants.
I do kind of wish that the thin wheels still left little ruts in the crop instead of just leaving it completely untouched. But you before they patched that in, it was like even the thin wheels would leave these ginormous ruts in the crop. So it's better this way than what it was, because now there's a benefit for buying the thin wheels, but I feel like it could be better.
You know what confuses me about using the thin wheels, and this is just me, is I'm putting the same weight on a lower interaction point. So shouldn't I sink deeper and rut worse?
You would make deeper ruts, but they wouldn't be as wide, so you wouldn't kill as much crop. But the crop that you do kill would be like completely completely unsavable.
Exactly. There has to be some like line here, and I think we've gone too far over into the mystical, magical fairy line.
Yeah. Well, so yeah, that's why I said like I wish you would leave some damage to your crops, just not as widespread damage.
You know what Farming Simulator 17 needs though, because we have big maps. The flying pig.
The flying pig.
Yeah. That mod spotlight that I did where it was someone had turned the helicopter into a pig.
Oh. Right.
But see, the thing is, it fertilized. You could fertilize with the flying pig. I don't want to understand where it came from. I wasn't going to ask, but you could fertilize with the flying pig.
Oh, man. I would. I would put it on my farm.
What we really need to do is we need to get a manure-based animal sooner rather than later.
Yes.
Because
pigs are cheaper.
I want greenhouses. And I reviewed this greenhouse that I want because it gets you an insane amount of money, and I'm stating that we're in Colorado, so therefore the hemp/marijuana greenhouse is perfectly legal.
Didn't they make that mod already?
That mod? Yeah, it's out.
I already reviewed
that mod.
Yeah.
The hemp one, yeah. Yes, but
I'm out of hard drive space.
Your hard drive's dead.
I have another hard drive, I just have to switch the recording folder. So, yeah. Brief break in the matrix for my viewers. Hello, my viewers. Sorry for that break in the matrix. I had to do some hard drive cleaning. So, Dare Tabbers has teleported all the way over here for you guys. Hi, Dare.
Hello. I don't understand why it took you so long to seed these fields. This is really fast.
Okay, when your working myth is 4 times the size of that, and your working speed is twice, so you're effectively working 8 times faster than I had to.
Well, your point being what exactly? I mean,
it sounds like the owner of the farm gets the good toys.
It sounds like a bunch of complaining by an employee who isn't properly motivated. A whip. And if you're a horse, sweet feed. Pretty much.
Yeah. So here's our Barola field, or cannoli. Cannoli, there you go.
We're going to sell it directly to the local Italian restaurant.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I want cannolis. Dang it.
We actually have a field that is seeded in cannoli. Oh, actually, how much wheat did we get off of that field? Like 12,000? Yep, 12,449. It's only going for 417 a ton, so wait for it. My philosophy for selling crops is, you know, don't hoard for a great demand in Farming Sim 17 because they're a lot more rare than they were in 15 and 13. But hoard for a green price. A green price means it's a good price, but it's not a great demand.
Okay. Sounds good to me.
And of course, in my in the last live stream that I did, I sold all the wheat because it was a green price, and then it was sunflower. Sold all the sunflower at a green price, and then literally like 15 minutes later got a great demand for sunflower, and I was like, ah.
Yeah, that sounds, you know, it's like a steam sale. You're going to buy it, and then you're going to be like, ah, it was cheaper.
It's always like the opposite of what you think it's going to do. It's like, oh, this game is obscure or really well known, so it's not going to go on sale. And then it goes on sale. Or, I'm going to wait for this game to go on sale. Or, like, on a flash sale, and it never does. And then you miss the original sale.
I'm sad they got rid of flash sales. Those were good. Now it's... I bought do you have Train Simulator whatever it is, which yeah, so there's a there's DLC I found. It's free, it's a handcart.
Oh really?
Yeah,
does it come with missions?
I don't know, I just downloaded it and I was just like, yeah, I'll play with that later. Yay, we did our first fertilizing.
Huzzah.
Grow faster.
Oh wait, so if I toggle my flashlight on, is my character actually holding a flashlight now?
No.
Darn. You would think with like the ability. No. Nope.
It's...
Man, like, vision. Light vision.
No, you smile. It's smile.
Not endorsed by
smile.
Crest.
I don't understand the people who get that whitening toothpaste all the time. It's like,
it's wearing down the enamel on your teeth.
Yeah.
Bleh. It also tastes really bad. I accidentally got a tube once.
Accidentally on purpose, I'm sure.
No. Well, it was on purpose in that it was the cheapest one, but I didn't know it was a whitening.
The crops still grow at night.
Yes.
That's stupid. Why haven't they fixed that?
they're growing off the nutrients in the ground as opposed to the nutrients from the sun. I don't know. I'm taking stabs in the dark here.
I don't mind that, but they should decrease the grow rate by 50% at night, because I always hate when you have to harvest in the middle of the night.
That's true, too. In game tomorrow afternoon.
I'm just waiting for the next grow phase.
Then we get one more layer of fertilizer.
Yay!
And then we get 90% yield. We get max yield on field 14, but 90% yield on 12 and 14. 12 and 14. 15 is the one that got plowed, so 15 gets the.
Oh my god, where's my map? Okay, I'm gonna ask this question because this is like a really, like, it's always bugged me since the first farm sim. Why in the world are my sheep all the way over there? Why are my pigs all the way up the hill? Why are my cows in town?
Plug for the Silvercrest Valley map, which fixes the starting area.
Yes, well. Oh, hey, it grew. Mush, go fertilize.
Yeah.
I'll slow time down again. I also did a good job on the sky. Looks really nice. I just want to watch you drive the derpy tractor.
Hopefully I can get lined up well.
Meh. I'm going to get out of the way so I don't get fertilized. I don't need any fertilizer. I'm well grown.
Nothing says goodnight like lime burns. Well, this isn't lime, is it?
No, probably not. I like the mod where you can actually see the physical, what is it, the Gwell Mist mod? Is that what the mod that would put the little pellets out?
I don't know. I never played with it. No. It sounds interesting, though.
Well, you're a lot of help.
Remember, I only have 200 hours in Farming Sim 15.
Yeah, you seem to have worked in a very tight box.
Yeah, pretty much all of my Farming Sim 15 time was multiplayer with Dr. V.
So your time was basically spent with chickens.
Against my will, yes.
I think I counted up and I had, by the end of the 15 videos, I had, not breaking up the packs, because the packs obviously would have more than that, but I had something like 700 mods that I looked at.
Holy cow.
And not all of them were actually done as Mod Spotlight. Some of them were used in, like, California Life or something like that, and never really spotlighted, and I just used them and moved on. So,
what was your the favorite series that you did for 15? Which one was the most fun for you?
I'm still enjoying Pennsylvania Life.
Right, yeah. I've seen that you're still publishing those, and you said you were going to do that at least until the new year, right?
Yeah, I know that the mod author has converted the map to work in 17, but most of the mods that I'm using are not converted, so I can't. Someone asked me just to switch everything into 17, but I can't, because a lot of the stuff is just not modded.
Hashtag UPK.
Yeah, I know, right?
I can't wait.
That was the best mod, bar none, for Farm Sim.
Yep.
I like how my microphone picks up the stupidest things, because I can't use my big mixing microphone. I'm playing with a little 16 gig USB thing on my desk because I forgot Friday to upload. Friday. No, Wednesday. I forgot to upload something for work. So it's sitting here to remind me to upload it on Monday.
Yeah, I'm not using my usual recording mic either. I'm using my Astrowave 50 mic. And that's just because that's the one that Steam wanted to use. Like, I can't get Steam to recognize my actual, like, boom mic for some reason.
Oh my god, I know. I can't get freaking Audacity to recognize Steam.
Oh.
That's why I finally gave up. I'm like, yeah, you're just gonna be mixed in with the game noise, and I'm gonna be separate because I can't get it to behave itself.
That's what I've always done.
So what are you going to do for Christmas now that by the time this goes live, it's going to be... Hold on, I need a calendar. I don't know what day it is. Hold on.
Oh, my God.
Calendar. That would be under C, usually. All right. So that was one and two. And we're in the third thing. Oh, my God. Why are you so difficult, Google? Yeah, I know. I want to see the next month. Quit being a pain in my butt. Thank you. One, two, three. So, we're on the Friday before the week before Christmas. Doesn't make any sense, does it?
Yeah.
This is somewhere around the 17th of December. So, what are you going to do for Christmas? That was a long way to get to that question.
Well,
it?
On the 17th, that's when I take National Registry, so that's what I'm going to be doing on the 17th.
You're going to be taking National. So they can say whether you're allowed to electrocute people.
Yeah, pretty much. That's the nice part about being in Ohio. Ohio is actually the state that started National Registry. So I just need my, like, once I have my National Registry, I automatically get my Ohio license. Some people, like, require you to take National Registry and then take the state test. But since Ohio started National Registry, I just have to take the National Registry test. And then I automatically get my Ohio license.
Ooh, aren't you special? Has this grown any? I'm not losing my mind, right? I can't tell if this has grown another stage or not. Does barley grow slower?
Confused. I don't know if barley grows slower or not. I think they all grow at pretty much the same speed.
Hold on. Where's my map of the... Oopsie. Growth stage. Yes, they all should be fertilized. And then we go one more, and they go dark green, and then we fertilize them again, and then they go to yellow, and then we spend way too much time harvesting them. Cool. So you're going to be taking the National Registry. Usually, historically, the past many, many years working, the 17th is the beginning of my 3 weeks off.
Ooh. Well, National Registry is only like 2 days, so.
Well, usually I take the week before Christmas, the week after Christmas, and the week of New Year's off. But this year I'm not going to be able to do any of that, so.
Oh no.
I don't know what I'm
going to
be doing. Because. I have way too much work to do, and unless I can magically make things happen between now and then, and not getting that time off.
Fair enough. So yeah, viewers, in case you're wondering, this is how I fertilize without GPS. I just look at my tractor from a top-down view so I can see where I'm fertilizing and where I'm not, so sorry if it's giving you like motion sickness or something.
That's pretty much what I do. Well, I do it from the back. Lazy people and their GPS.
It's realistic. That's what I'm dealing with. I don't care if it's realistic or not. I'm just saying it's realistic.
You know, it would be more, would make this even more realistic if we had a sudden rainstorm and then the tractors sink into the mud. That would make it more realistic.
Yep. Especially because this is the Pacific Northwest area. Or it's supposed to be the Pacific Northwest area.
Yeah. Wait, it is? Because then they got stuff wrong.
That's what they said. They said it was supposed to be, like, Oregon, Washington, Canada. At least that's what they said when they, like, before the game was released. I don't know if they changed anything about it. It feels a little bit like Appalachia to me.
Where's the weather forecast?
I don't know if there is one, now that I think about it.
Because it used to be something that, you know, it would be helpful to know what the weather is coming up.
Yeah. Let's see. No, there's not.
Yeah.
What's up with that?
Okay. Yeah, that's weird. One, we've gone more than a day and it hasn't rained, so it's not the Pacific Northwest.
Yeah. There you go.
You know one thing FarmSim should do, also, along with, you know, all the other things that we've already listed. But there should be a date up there.
And then
and
seasons.
When it get, yeah. Kind of like, I hate to say it because it's a crap game, but it kind of like Farm Expert.
Yeah, kind of bad to make any kind of reference to that.
Yeah. The fact that I can say, hey, Farm Expert did this really, really well. Oh, that's horrible.
It was what I said about when I left a review on Professional Farmer 2016 or 2017 or whatever, is that it has some good ideas, but extremely, extremely poor execution.
Yeah, oh, I found out why Farm Expert 2017 flickered like nobody's business for me.
Why?
Because I had SLI turned on. You know, like a modern gamer.
Uh-huh. So
turn off SLI and it fixes.
Because it was designed on and designed for potatoes.
Pretty much. Well, it's the same thing that, oh, whoever they are, that released Bioshock Remastered.
Uh-huh.
They remastered it for a potato because you have to turn your SLI off in order for the textures not to load.
Wow.
Yeah. It was fantastic when I found that out. And the bigger pain in the butt is because the way SLI works on my box, I have to turn off my my Logitech system for my keyboard and my mouse, which disables my keyboard and mouse's extra functionalities in order to turn off SLI. And then once SLI is off, then I have to go turn it on and hope that it actually reconnects properly.
Ouch.
Why does that look like a fire?
Yeah, I don't have SLI like on my computer, honestly. But I do have a 970, so it's not horrible. At least I have a good card. And it's not SLI.
Yeah,
but
I picked up the extra 980 and it was sitting on the floor for like 3 months. I was like, I should probably put that in and turn SLI on. Not realizing that, you know, people still don't make their games for SLI.
Well, people are just barely starting to make their games for 64-bit.
Oh, gosh, yes. Oh, I thought the house was on fire, but it's some really brilliant orange curtains. Apparently we have a giant pumpkin inside this house.
It's the Great Pumpkin.
Who are you, Charlie Brown?
Yeah.
Does that make me Lucy, so I can pull the football out when you're trying to kick it?
Well, you're dressed for it.
Thanks. Appreciate that. chickens! How many eggs have you laid? Oh, we have eggs. How many eggs? I don't know. I have to collect them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't like the eggs all over the yard. Yay! Just like Shadow said, this is stupid, chickens. We made you a chicken house. Use the chicken house.
They're probably afraid to go inside it. They're like, it's too rickety.
Well, that's because you made it.
Well... okay. Yeah, you got me there.
Are we gonna have enough fertilizer for another run?
You mean like another full cycle of crops?
Well, I mean another... enough fertilizing of our fields, because we have one fertilizer to go, don't we?
Nope, we're done.
Are we?
Yep. We did one with the cedar.
Oh, you're right, then... we did, okay.
Yep, okay, and good. We're out of fertilizer, so, yeah, there's that.
there's that, yes.
Yeah.
I'll have to take one of the other tractors in and put front loader arms on it or something. I've got a big head and little arms. What movie? That was the movie. Something involving a T-Rex being part of the evil. Was that it? Oh, okay.
Yep.
We have over $4,000 carry cost on our farm.
Yep. You want to know why? It's because of this harvester right here.
I know it's because of that harvester right there. That's why I'm getting the...
yeah.
I'm getting the repair mod. It costs 14 grand to repair that harvester, but it'll fix that problem.
Oh wow.
What? No, it's definitely worth, cuz the author actually stated the math that he used for calculating it, and you do that and it resets it back to zero, basically.
That is really handy.
The cost, of course, will get exorbitant over time.
Right. Because it's supposed to replicate like replacing engines and stuff like that.
Exactly. Oops. I wish this opened.
Right? That would be awesome. Keep the truck down in there. Or something down in there.
Like, Egg Simulator Historical Farming, where you had to, like, go in there and go into the building to get the seeds.
Uh-huh. When you walked toward me, like, you walked through me and my character hopped up onto your shoulders and back down.
What?
Oh, I'm standing on the fence immediately to your left.
Are you? Because according to my game, you're standing in the field.
Nope. Directly good. Behind you now.
That's nice. You are standing in that road, at the edge of the road over there.
Good old farming giants. Simulator, positional desync. And actually, I run into that problem on my dedicated server all the time, too, so it might actually just be me.
Yeah, it's just you. You are a positional desync.
Yeah. 404 position right. Not found. I need to stop
running...
I need to stop running my internet through, like, 12 VPNs, probably.
We're in the last stage of growing. Oh, I'm sure it is. So, I guess we can go and get the equipment parked up and ready to go.
Still no fall damage. They need to take a leaf out of that giant machine simulator. And if you fall from more than 12 feet, you die.
You know what you mean, like I did?
Yeah.
that game was fine, except for the story just got stupid so fast.
Yeah. Pretty much, as a rule of thumb, if there's simulator in the title, don't expect a good story. As a rule of thumb.
Yeah, and if you do have a story, make it not stupid.
What was it? Part where like a bridge collapsed on a truck, and they're like, "Don't worry about don't worry about calling the fire department or anything. We're gonna take this huge crane over and lift the pieces of the bridge off of the truck."
Yes, and there was another. There was a part where, well, you're driving a freaking giant mining dump truck down a 2-lane road.
Yep. I remember seeing that.
Yeah, I was like, that's 380 tons driving down a 2-lane. That's not happening.
How does a police officer go about pulling over a car, a vehicle like that? You have to climb up the front.
I have no idea. Yeah.
We actually have a lot of mines around here. Actually, not mines, a lot of quarries around here, so...
You just wait until it runs out of fuel.
Yeah. Which will take, on average, about 12 minutes.
Yeah, pretty much. Hey, there's an extra fuel drum in here.
Now, why can't they put that level of detail in everything that they do?
Right.
I mean, don't get me wrong. There's a ton of improvements in 17, in my opinion, over its predecessors. But I'm going to be nitpicky, and I'm going to pick out every single way that Giants can improve that's possible. Because that's how
exactly.
They will continue to improve.
Alright, time to harvest. Should I set the harvesting blades high or low? It doesn't matter, I don't know what it does anyway.
Set blades to stun.
Yes.
Actually, let me check the price on canola. Great, we have no green prices.
Woohoo!
Yay, hard mode.
Hey, we just have to make our carry cost. Wait. We pay loan interest, but do we actually pay off the loan? No, we're just paying the interest.
No.
It's an interest-only loan,
interest.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
That's stupid! Should be paying principal as well.
Yeah, like, I wish you could adjust your payment and be like, I want to pay more than the minimum payment. Get this paid off quickly.
Also, the other mod that would be great in 17, especially in hard mode, is the rock mod, the rock spawn mod.
I never played with that either. I noticed that you have it in Pennsylvania Life, right?
Yes, I do. Oh. And it's only caused a couple of small problems. I don't need you at all. We've gotten 14% off that run.
Oh, I'm bored.
Fine, here, have a pipe. Is the pipe going out? I can't tell.
Extend the peace pipe.
No? Is it out?
Yep.
Okay. I can't tell because I can't see it in any of my mirrors.
Yeah, that's another thing Giants can improve on. Either allow us to adjust the mirrors or put the mirrors in an actual position of function.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I know modders get around it by using the cameras. So there's the little cameras at the brain.
Mm-hmm.
But that's a nice workaround, but it's a workaround.
Oh, I did think of something that Alt is used for in Farming Simulator. If you have the drive control mod, Alt gives you a camera of the pipe. Like, it basically sticks a camera at the end of the pipe so you can see if you're over your tipper or not.
Alt is important to viewers because I was going to put push-to-talk on, but my push-to-talk is Alt, and I couldn't figure out. Neither me nor Shadow knew what Alt was used for.
Yeah. Alt is just one of those buttons that's there if you need it.
Right.
Like, literally the only thing I can think of using Alt for at all is Alt codes for getting, like, special characters using the numpad and Control-Alt-Delete.
But Alt is more useful than that stupid key to the right of the right-hand Windows key.
Oh yeah, all it does is pull up the right click, right? Like the right click menu on the desktop.
Yeah, I'm like, well, you're useless, go away. Be something useful.
Be a dedicated push-to-talk key. No, that's way too inconvenient.
It is way too inconvenient.
Unless you use the arrow keys like a freak.
You mean like Stacco Gloss?
Yes! Stacco, I know I haven't met you in person, but I've been watching your videos for a long time.
I think Gray uses those keys too. But Gray's a lefty, so...
Okay, well that's a little more understandable.
He gets a pass.
Yeah.
But I still want Gray to play Silent Service 2.
That would be interesting. I don't know what Silent Service 2 is.
It's a submarine game back from the days when I was young. And you probably were in diapers or something.
You're not that old.
My Silent Service 2 came on 5 1/4-inch floppies.
Okay. The last thing I used floppy drives for was for saving word processor projects on in second and third grade. But that was 2002, 2003, so my school was completely out of date.
2002, 2003, and you were in second or third grade?
Yep.
Yeah. You weren't even in diapers. You weren't even conceived yet, my friend.
Jeez.
I've been gaming since 1983.
That's 10 years before I was born. Well, you act a lot younger than you are, Dare, if you want to take that as a compliment.
And I don't hold a candle to Gray.
Yeah. Gray's like, I remember when the only things we played with were sticks and hoops.
Gray remembers when they played rock, paper, scissors, and they didn't have any scissors.
I like that one. Rock, paper, sword.
That works.
Yeah, Dar, I thought you were, like, maybe 10 years older than me.
Yes, I act my shoe size, not my age.
Ha, I like that. That's a good one, too.
Oh, Harvester, you are so small. You're so small, Harvester. Get bigger! Eat your Wheaties!
I wish you could extend the pipes on the harvesters. Like, buy a pipe that you can swap out so you can put a bigger head on it. But, obviously, like, in real life, if you use a bigger head, that might, like, burn out the PTO or transmission or however combine head works.
You just put a supercharger on it. That's all you need to do.
Put 24 bottles of nitrous.
Yes!
Speaking of my...
Oh god, you don't have nitrous, do you?
No, I don't. I drive a Honda Accord.
So it's ripe for nitrous. Everybody puts nitrous on an Accord, right? Makes it go the speed limit.
Yeah. It's a Honda Accord Coupe, so it has the fast lines. It just doesn't use them.
Yeah, pretty much.
But my uncle just traded in his Dodge Dart and got a Dodge SRT4, and has, like, he bought it this way. He didn't do it himself, but it is, like, the engine's going to explode, I swear. He's got way too much stuff crammed into that engine, and yeah, he's gotten several tickets in it. It's like, he's impossible driving slow in that car.
The best possible situation is that it explodes spectacularly on the highway somewhere on a dark night where it's raining and cold. I'm now confused. Is my pipe going out or in? I don't.
In. It is now in.
Good. I don't have any sort of switches or buttons or displays in my cab of my tractor made by Giants to tell me where my harvesting pipe thingamajiggy is.
Yeah, Giants, get your act together.
I mean, let's. I mean, this is a pretty, you know, not a super complicated cockpit, but I mean, we've got a bunch of knobs to twiddle and switches to flip, and every single one of those to be actionable in Flight Simulator.
Yeah, even freeware. It might not actually do anything in freeware, but you could flip the switch or twiddle the dial and feel
right,
like
and
you're
you get that very wonderful clink noise of flipping the switch.
Mm-hmm. I actually know somebody who is I know them via YouTube. They're one of my YouTube subscribers that is still in high school, and he's building, like, a, you know, a home flight deck with, like, he's wiring switches himself, like, building the thing himself. It's pretty impressive. I was like, I wish I could do that. I mean, I built my desk, but that's about as far as my building stuff knowledge goes. I can replace a sink or replace a light fixture. That's about it.
I mean, up until these last two computers, I've built every computer since my Packard Bell 286 SX16.
Oh, I build my own computers, but I mean as far as, like, actually, like, building, like, you know, buying just, like, a regular switch and hooking that up to, like, a mother, like, you know, to a switchboard and programming that and everything, I can't do that. That's beyond me. So yeah, I built my
It's
own
not
computers.
Beyond you, you just have better use for your time.
Fair enough.
That's my excuse. I have better use for my time. Someone else can do it. It's like the idea of laying carpet in my house. Someone else can do it. I could do it, but I've got a better use for my time.
Yeah.
Ooh, are you full already?
Well, 91%.
Ah. Well, that's good.
No, it's 7,293 liters. Just in case you were wondering the exact amount.
I wasn't, but thank you.
You're welcome. Oh. There we go. We're good.